final trade of the day. Joining me now is Kevin Cook of Zacks.com, here to take a look at Apple as we get closer to those earnings.
Yep.
Thanks for coming on the show.
Tuesday, Apple reports, and you know, I think the stock is being held down because of expectations that the iPhone 8 is going to be late.
So I have to add at this juncture that I have a source who's very, very good at following developments in Apple. And what he taught me is, as soon as Apple comes out with a new product, we start to get this barrage of, it's going to be delayed, there's a bug, there's this, there's that.
Right.
So you really have to know how to separate the actual news from the noise, because there's always noise surrounding Apple launches.
Yeah,
and yet they always happen
exactly.
Pretty much on time.
Yeah, and the company just continues to execute. And it's, you know, it's not, obviously the iPhone is the biggest part of their sales.
Exactly.
And the cash generator, but Apple's doing a lot of other things. They're building out this ecosystem. They have a secret design lab, just like Facebook, just like Google, where they're creating products and stuff that we don't even know about yet with, you know, AI, VR, AR. So I want to be a buyer of a call spread here and go out to October and buy the 150, 165 call spread for about 5.25. Now, we'll miss that October earnings report. So if you have a more of a long-term view, which I do, you can go out to December, buy the same call spread, 150, 165, and pay about 550. Gives you a little more time.
So for somebody who might not want to do an option strategy, tell us what your target prices would be on Apple and why you're setting up for this play to reach a certain level.
So in this strong bull market where tech continues to lead, I see Apple going to 170 in the next, say, 6 to 9 months.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good to have you here. Thank you so much.
Thank you.